up guys, hopefully you guys are all having a good day. So today I'm going to be removing one of my friend's leaf springs on his truck. He has a Toyota pickup. I'm not really familiar with how to do things with them because I mostly work on my Nissan, but I'm going to take you guys through the process of me removing the leaf spring so it can sit a little lower in the rear. He's running air shocks right now, so that would be able to mess with how high and low he could drive in the way. But we're going to be removing it, see how low he can get. But other than that, I'll take you guys through the process, like I said, of how to do things more step by step. I'm going to try to have more like footage of me doing it and stuff like that with him helping me record. But let me know what you guys think about these videos, if I should make more, like all my friends and stuff like that. And I'll show you guys and introduce you to my friend once I get to the spot where we're going to be working on it. All right, so this is my friend Axel's truck we're going to be working on today. So right now we have to put it on jacks. We're gonna jack it up from the diff, and then we're gonna put two jack stands to be able to mess with the leaf springs. What's your name?
My name is Axel. I drive a 1991 Toyota pickup, and I'm trying to lower it, you know.
Yeah, so he's kind of shy, but we're gonna try to get this thing done today as fast as we can, but take our time with it, because we do have to mess with the leaf springs and get everything right and situated. But once I jack it up and everything, I'll put a little time lapse of us jacking it up and everything. So and after everything, I'll show you how to remove the leaf springs if you guys ever want to do blocks or anything like that. Simple.
Looking forward to the transition in my life I'm about to make. I'm on a mission for a feeling, went from feeling good to great. Life is all about perspective and the picture that you paint. If you think in negativity, don't dwell on what you ain't. Oceanside, California, that's my city and my state. I represent in every verse, my city never does it plain. I'm trying to get off EBT, enjoy lobster with some steak. In due time, young Padawan, more traction I'm gonna gain. And wean myself off of that doubt. I hate when these people pout, mad cause they cannot get out. That's not my fault, figure it out. I had to do it, so do you. No free rides or meals to mouth. Nobody cares about your problems, all these blessings need to count. Sunny summer days with no clouds up in the sky. Reminisce on being a kid, what a time to be alive. The total ignorance was bliss, I had to open up my eyes. Look around the scenery, not gonna let life pass me by. Sunny summer days with no clouds up in the sky. Reminisce on being a kid, what a time to be alive.
Alright, so what we did right now is we put it on jack. We took the tires off, or the rims off. And it gives us more space to, you know, be able to take the, what's it called, the U-bolts for the blocks off to be able to remove this middle leaf spring. So we're going to be removing this one, leaving the top one and the bottom one, and this one's going to come out. And we're going to see how it sits. He's running on a 3-5-inch block. So that's what he's running right now, in a way. But we're going to remove it and see how it sits after that. All right, so we removed the middle leaf spring, this one, and that's the bottom one, and that's the one that was in the middle. So this is how it's gonna look. This one's gonna be underneath here, so it's only gonna be these two. And if you could see on the other side, there's three. 1, 2, 3. You take the blocks off. Underneath there's a little nut, and then the top you have to hold it up with vice grips. I'll show you guys once I do on this side. We have to hold this side with vice grips on top, and then the bottom there's a nut. It's a 14 millimeter nut. You just loosen them, the bottom comes off. Then there's these brackets. So I used the, where is it? It's over there. I used that crowbar to put it underneath here and force it to bend over, and then this one should just fall off, and then just put this one back onto this one, bolt them back together, and just put everything back how it was. And I'll show you guys once I start doing this side. I'll show you guys once that side, this side's all done, and then I'll start showing you guys how to do it step by step on the other side. I just wanted to see how much of a difference it was doing this compared to my truck, but it's rarely similar. It's basically the same thing. So let me get this side done, and then I'll start showing you guys how to do the other side. All right, so these are the blocks that he has. So I'm gonna be taking these off, put them to the side so I could be able to access the bolt underneath. This is the bolt, and then this is the bottom one that holds these blocks, is like the top of the bolt, which I have to hold on with vice grips so I could be able to loosen this one to be able to take the middle one off. So let me get that started and get the blocks off first. So this is the nut I was talking about that has to be held on with the vice grips, like this. That one held there, and then uses the ratchet with the 14 millimeter to get this bolt underneath here. And it should loosen right away. If it's not as bad as other, if it's not bad, rusted together, stuff like that. But. That one comes off, the bottom one, which is this one, comes off. We're gonna keep this one, and then we're gonna wanna take this middle one off with the crowbar to bend. I'm gonna try to unbend these right here, just bend them up that way, and there's gonna be two more over here to bend up, and that one should come off. I don't know how other people do it, but this is the way I did it on the other side. So the other side's done already. Just bend them like that. Bend them like that. It should come up. Thank you.
It's behind you.
And that's basically how you do that. It's considered like monolith or something. I'm not really sure what people say, but he wanted to take the middle one off so he could sit a little lower. So we did that. So all we got to do now is just put the blocks back and the U-bolt, these things back into how they were, and reinstall everything and see how it sits. Also, if you guys could see, he is C-notched. Or step notch, whatever you guys consider this. So he has room for the diff to go up more higher. So that's another reason why he wanted to sit lower. He relocated his shocks. And if you guys are wondering what shocks you guys want to ever run, recommend air shocks. He got them at AutoZone or somewhere, and then just run the lines back here. And then he puts air through up there. So like he could either lower or lift it with those shocks, but it all has to be done manually anyways. So let me finish up. Everything I need to put is back together, like on this side, with the blocks and everything. And once all that's done, I'll show you guys the finished product. I kind of showed you guys in a way how to do everything. So right now I just need to install everything back on how it was, and then see how it sits. All right, so we finished everything. We put the wheels on and everything's on back on the truck. So here's the wheel. It's not sitting on the ground yet. It's still on jacks. But let me show you guys everything that was there. So it's basically just the blocks put back, the whatever those are, the U-bolts. And then there was the leaf spring here. So now it's just this one and the bottom one, the thick one, and this other one that's connected, the long one. I'm not really sure what to call them, but you get the point. So here's the setup now. And now the only thing that we got to do is take it off the jacks, torque down the wheels, and I'll show you guys how it sits after this. And I'll show you guys when I'm putting it down off the jack with anything, with nothing underneath, like the jack will be out. And I'll just slowly drop it and show you guys how it sits. Hopefully it sits a little lower, but if not, then he's going to have to do something else. But at least I helped him, you know? Right?
Yeah.
You better be thankful for my freaking work.
Yeah, thank
you. Yeah, but that's all this channel is about, is just helping my friends, helping anybody. So it's like, if you guys ever need help, let me know. If you guys are near the area, and if you guys need work like this, then I'll try to help you as best as I can. But yeah, let me drop this and finish up. And so right now I took the jacks off, and now I'm just gonna lower this jack slowly and see how it sits and how the fitment is in the back. Hopefully it's low enough as much as you want it to, but we'll have to see. So as you can see, it went lower than, it went way lower than what he used to drive it at. But he also has the air shocks, so if anything, he could just raise them up, put some air in them through back here, and it'll raise up the truck. And he could either drive it this low or higher. But yeah, this is what's gonna do it for today. That's what we had planned. That's what I had planned for today, just to make a little video of him and lowering his truck a little more. But thank you guys, if you guys enjoyed the video, hit that like button, subscribe if you guys are not, and thank you guys for the support of everything you guys have given me, and just all the comments, everything, bad comments, good comments, like I say, I could only make myself better from those. And thank you guys, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.
Be young. Yeah.